Hello everyone! Welcome to my channel, The Ava Wonderland. I'm Ava. On my channel, I will share videos about my art, handcraft ideas, and my lifestyle. Hopefully, you will enjoy them. Today's project is a simple wall decor painting. It can show your good taste in art and 100% beginner friendly. The only thing you need is a pair of functional hands and some art supplies. Before we start, I'd like to give you some background information about this style. Minimalism. It's a super popular concept for lifestyle right now, but it has been popular in art for more than a half century. There are tons of artworks and artists in minimalist style. Follow me in this video. We will create a minimalist painting that matches your interior design. Let's start. By the way, if you are a big fan of tidy up and have certain level of OCD about it, you're gonna love this video.
First step, definitely is prepare art materials. Pencil, eraser. Sorry, my eraser is super dirty. Don't follow me this way. I promise you, I always clean them when I use them. Masking tape, acrylic marker, or another name, you can call it paint marker. Bristol board and ruler. Now we start to design the outline. First, I want to leave 1.5 inch border and apply masking tape on the edges. Usually, high quality masking tape is adhesive enough to make a strong connection to the drawing surface, but not too strong to remove the paper. If you feel your tape is too strong before you apply it on your painting, you can tape it on your clothes to reduce the adhesive effectiveness. And then I draw some random rectangles with overlapping. You can design them whatever you like, no rules. I didn't make a super complicated design. Do you remember our topic for this project? Minimalism. This is a color chart I made for my paint marker. I choose my color palette from it. I love loud and bold colors, so I choose green, purple, and red. Those high contrast colors as my primary color. But they have similar value, around middle key to low key. So I choose light blue, yellow, and pink as the accent colors to enlighten this painting. Now I start to paint from the biggest one. Tape the edges first. Be careful on the corner. Please make sure it's 90 degrees. Because it's a super simple and clean painting, people will be easier to notice any mistake on it. You can use scissors and a utility knife to cut and shape the tape. I pick the green color for this one. I want green to be my dominant color. When you paint close to the edge, the direction should be from tape to the shape, which will press some air out of the tape, kind of seal the edge. Make sure the edge will be sharp and clean. And then enjoy the wonderful moment. Just keep moving your hand. Don't need thinking, don't need use your brain. I call it painting meditation. Enjoy. Also, probably you can play some music. Okay, now it's time to tear the tape off. Please be careful, don't rush. Slowly tear them off. Look, the beautiful, smooth, sharp, and clean edges. I feel satisfied and joyful when I tear the tapes off. And then we just keep repeating the process. Tape the outline of every shape, paint it, tear the tape off. Also, I will reuse those tapes for two reasons. First, save money, of course. Second, because their adhesive force has been reduced, so we'll be more comfortable to tear off them from the paper.
Giveaway time! If you subscribe me and leave comments, you will have a chance to win some free cute Halloween cat stickers. And don't forget to check my art and comics account on Instagram. Thank you!
In this project, I chose painting markers to color the painting because it's easily controlled for beginners, and you don't need to buy too many art supplies at once. Only pens are enough. Suppose you choose to use gouache or acrylic. In that case, you have to buy brushes, color mixing palettes, prepare water containers, and do some extra work to clean them up. If you have had these tools, you definitely can use brush to paint this painting. But if you are a 100% beginner or afraid of make a big mess, I highly recommend using paint markers. For the final result, I gave up the blue. I feel 6 different colors in this painting a little bit too much. Now I finish coloring all shapes, so the most wonderful moment is coming! Tear the outline masking tape off. You can't believe how relaxing I feel at this moment. Look, the sharp, clean edges. I love it. Basically, the whole process of this painting is a meditation for me. Without too much thinking, just repeat a simple move and get a clean, tidy result. This is the best art activity to release your pressure. And then you can frame it to hang on your wall. Sorry, I rent an old house right now. My wall, kind of old-fashioned. So I photoshopped my painting in some home decor marketing photos, which I found online, to demonstrate the potential visual effects on your wall.
Do you like this painting? If you like it or it fits your home decor style, you can follow the process to make more pieces. Hopefully, you will enjoy this video. See you next week!
If you enjoy my video, please subscribe me and then don't forget to give me a thumbs up. Also, if you have any questions and suggestions, please leave a comment for me.